I'm replacing the short drive axles on left side. This is a front wheel drive. I have the automatic transmission. Both axles on both sides are the same for the automatic transmission, for the manual shifting too. For the front wheel driving car, the all wheel driving car, the right one, it's different. It's different length. The left one is the same. Be sure to get the genuine parts, Volvo, or GKN makes them for Volvo. Many aftermarket ones will have vibrations into the steering wheel even when new, so be really careful. You need to have this damper. Both are made by GKN as well. But the first thing is, before you want to remove any bolt, remove the center bolt. 40 millimeter has to be replaced because it's a stretch bolt, and see if you can push your axle back in there a little bit, see if it moves. Especially XC90, I think it's getting stuck into the hub sometimes. Dealership will put those tread lock because this bolt gets loose and they have problems with anti-skid messages and stuff. It's really not worth fighting, putting on the press and stuff like this. You have videos on YouTube. If you put it on a press to remove the axle shaft from the hub, you will damage the wheel bearing. It's really not worth. Just go ahead and replace the whole wheel spindle with a second-hand drive shaft and call it a day. The second thing you want to see, it comes out from the transmission. Another area when it gets stuck really, really bad, even main dealers cannot remove it. So what I do, I try to use this one. You also have an orange, a long range, log range. It has this kind of an end. So I'll try to insert it right underneath, just pry, and it comes out. But this one is very easy to remove. If it's stuck, don't fight. You may try tapping on it with a hammer. One of the things people say to try on internet is put the transmission in neutral to rotate the transmission, or maybe lift the other wheel and then rotate the axle just a certain rotation and try to pry, then rotate again, try to pry again, and keep rotating like this and try to pry a different rotation, so different position of the CV joint. That may cause the ring to just, the locking ring to just center itself at some moment, depends on the rotation, center itself to come out easier, but sometimes it's totally stuck in there. If it's really stuck, just detach the boot, leave the casing inside the transmission, detach the boot and try to slide out the shaft. Sometimes there are three metal bumps that will prevent it from sliding out. Of course, it's a very messy job. You just grind those bumps, clean those shaving metals, and just replace the other side, the other end of the axle, and leave this casing into the transmission. That's how you do it. Okay, let's just go for it. Remove the brakes complete. I did hang mine with a wire on the strut, so you don't hang it by the hose. That's really important. And remove them complete with the bracket, and these bolts should be replaced in theory 15 millimeters. Don't overforce on them. These are alloy bolts. Be careful with them. You need to detach the ABS wire. It's very important because this wire is very sensitive. So detach it here, and you need to undo the bolt inside. Never pull on this wire to remove the sensor. Don't do that because you are going to damage the connection to the sensor even if you slightly pull on it. What you want to do, get a screwdriver, a flat one, go underneath here. You will see the tip of the sensor right at top of the reluctor ring, and just pry it upwards. Sometimes it's stuck, but you just pry it like this. It's up to you to see. You'll actually see the tip of the sensor, really just the tip of it, and you have these gears. You will see the tip of the sensor sits right on top of it. Slide the screwdriver in between and pop it up. Remove the top bolt of the strut. The lower bolt, I will just break it loose so as to rotate a little bit. You do have a camber adjustment. You may mark it before loosening up the bolts. Notice how much edge is here. And by the way, these bolts, I always put them like this toward the rear of the car. It's easier to access, not the other way. For the strut bolts, I did use a half an inch drive with a 2 feet pry bar. The socket on the nut size is 13 by 16 for the nut, and on the other side 18 millimeters. Okay, However, these bolts sometimes are really, really stuck in there, and I will advise you, if you fight a lot, to remove them. Replace the bolts, because I recently broke two of these at the junkyard, so they were already very, very weak from being forced on. So replace them just to be safe. The actual axle removal, what I did is, before I did remove it from the transmission just to see it works, it's coming out. Now I had to put it back inside the transmission, clip it back all the way. I did also push into this inner CV joint all the way in. It moves like this, so push it all the way. What you want to do is having the shorter length of the axle. That's why you push everything all the way into that side. Now the axle shaft will slide out and also in, but really just tight. You need to find the rotation position. Don't forget, important, hold on a sec. This seal, many mechanics throw it, and I need to replace mine, I think it's chipped. Many mechanics throw it, that's a bad idea. This is a seal on the inner side of the wheel bearing. Yes, the bearing does have a seal for itself, but this is protecting that seal even better, so your wheel bearing will last much longer. And this thing goes one way, let me see here. It goes, it's the other way. So careful not to chip it. I usually put it inside first and then I slide it, but careful not to chip it, not to damage. One last thing I will say, I do prefer to spread some coat with some grease, with some rust protector, both here in the inner edge, both in the outer edge. This is the ABS ring, and these are problematic because they rust underneath and the rust will just push upwards and just cause a crack, and you get an anti-skid message on the dash. So that's how you protect these things. And I also like to put grease here on both sides. Now this is the clip that sometimes will get it stuck inside the transmission, and especially the aftermarket one will have the wrong size clip. My suggestion, if you get one, let's say it's aftermarket or used or whatever, and you try to push it into the transmission and it doesn't go in easily, don't force, because you are going to get it stuck, and for whatever reason you need to replace it later on, maybe it's vibrating or something like this, you won't be able to remove it. So, and some people were saying try to replace this clip with the genuine one. It doesn't work, because when you move it from there and you try to put it back, it will just bend open. It's impossible to get it to the correct size. Be sure to grease the locking ring before you install the axle shaft inside the transmission. It's going to be easier the next time you remove it from there. We just talk a little bit about the other axle shaft, or the long one. Difference is it's longer, it's nastier to get in place, and it has a carrier bearing. The lower part of the bracket with two bolts, when you remove the bolts, you need to tap into the bracket, because sometimes it gets stuck on the bearing. You may want to check the bearing for smooth rotation. And also sometimes the bearing itself gets stuck into the upper bracket, the fixed bracket. Just stop on it. Sometimes when you put it back in place, especially if you put grease at the tip of the splines, it's difficult to slide the axle shaft into the transmission. However, there is no clip, securing clip on this side, only on the shorter side. So you really need to push it with your hands. It's a little bit, I mean, it's tough sometimes. It's annoying, it gets frustrating. And also the bottom of the bracket, the removable part, it goes only one way. If you put it the other way, it's not going to align correctly with the bolt hole. So make sure you put it, you find the right position and put some grease on it so it doesn't get stuck next time. And you need to fight a little bit. It's good to have a helper pushing into the shaft from the other side.